Alrighty. So I hope you guys enjoyed that first story time about me losing my boopy boop doo doo. Da 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 doo doo. Do a pop chick. My boo-doo guy. Yeah. My boo-doo guy. Yes, from within. So today, I hope you guys see, you know, the title down there. It's about when I first found out that I was actually transgender. Well, not necessarily transgender at that time, because back then it was just like either you're a boy or a girl. I didn't feel comfortable with my body. So I'm gonna try to make this kind of like not too long of a video, because my first story time was 30 minutes, but you know I'm trying to clock that watch time, you know what I'm saying? I'm trying to give you some watch time up in here. So I'm gonna try to, you know, give out a smaller detail to the story, and then later on in previous videos, I'm gonna extend to this one. How about that? I think that'd be dope, because I see that we're now like slowly trying to, you know, get to know each other and become, you know, like that type version, you know what I'm saying? And yes, I got my glasses time because, you know, I need some Moscato. Boom, boom. Dween. And my background sway. Yes, tonight I'm giving effervescent. Got Rihanna going with the winds. You know, I got my candles going. You know, I got our Anisha background finally going with the winds. Fabulous. That's how I do it. So, you know what I'm saying? For my trans girl also that are of color that are out there, I've been actually, like, getting used to, like, my body being on hormones. And I used to shake. My battery just tried to play a game on me. I used to shave. So, like, these are the old shave marks type versions. I know you can probably see them, which is not hot. But, you know, who cares? Because, like, I am transgender like that. Like, everybody already know. But I be beat. So, today is going to be more of a real natural video. Today's going to be you up close with me with my flaws and how, you know, I see myself in my judge. You know what I'm saying? It's not a bad thing. Like, you know, you got to be confident when you're ugly and when you're not. So, I do that. So I've been using lightning fade. Do you see how I have my like shadow here? Like it was way worse. Like I've actually been using this lightning cream for like about a good like month and a half, 2 months now type version-ish. I know you guys like that, huh? Keeping up with the lingo. Eventually I would have a dictionary out with all my words and everything so people can actually get the understanding what I'm really talking about up in this bitch. But majority of you already know who I am, so you know what I'm saying? You guys already know the flow from within. But my fade is starting to go away, you know what I'm saying? Like, it used to be bad. Like, I did not like it. Like, I used to hate feeling like being clocked. But ever since I've been using it, it's gotten lighter. So I'm actually liking this because this was way worse than what it was. Like, when I mean by way worse, like, probably, like, a good, like, 85% worse than what it is now. Like, now it's starting to actually work for me. But you gotta rock your flaws in order to be that bitch, you know what I'm saying? So I'm just letting you guys know. This is only the beginning of what it is. So I'm about to turn this shit out real quick. Boom, give you guys Lisa Left Eye. Ow, doom, boom. Ow, bow, bow, boom. I do not stand behind this TLC product, okay? Or project from within. I need to stop drinking, but from within. Okay, I got I'm trying to pronounce Supernova, baby. I'm just trying to get my... You know what I'm saying? Like, from within. But I am rocking another Chanel. Bow, boom, boom. So back to topic about me finding out.
So for me, in a little quick nutshell, let's break this shit down. So when I was really, really, really young, well, let me put it like, when I first came out of the cooter box, I didn't actually really come out of the cooter box. Like, my mom had to actually, like, have me, like, C-section baby type version. And, you know, I basically was not coming out of the vagina twat. She was not. She said, I'm not coming down that. I don't, nope, nope. I got to come out of I gotta come out of the whom before the what? Like, already before I even get here, I gotta come through coochie. I am not having it. So basically, she was in labor with me for like a long time, I guess, or whatever, you know, story told by family that I really don't really know that much anymore. So, you know, no shade, but shade. Anyways, so basically, she was in labor with me too long because I wouldn't come out natural, so they have to C-section me out, I guess. So basically, she was trying to shame Atlanta be known, like, you know, like, I just feel like, you know, he ain't gonna be coming out, like, he don't wanna come out, like, I don't know what's wrong type version. I was just a lazy ass bitch. But eventually, you know, I came out C-sectioned, you know what I'm saying? And then boom, you know, I was here. Like, I feel like when I woke up into myself knowing that, like, I was a human and I was young at the time and I was exploring and feeling from what I can remember, because, you know, that's how authentic I'm trying to bring it back, because I can remember a lot, which is really creepy, but I can remember a lot. But as far back as I can remember is when I was really, 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 like, really, really young. Like, girl toys were like my theme, like sparkles and unicorns and glitters and things. Like, it was more my sway. I felt like I would just always look at those kind of things and be more attracted to those type of things, you know. I just thought it was the norm. Like, I felt like that's what I should do. Like, this is what I like. Like, it's pretty, it's pink, it's purple, like those type of colors and things like that. So I always was like, felt soft in the inside. Like, I never felt like I was hardcore or anything like that. I've always felt like very sensitive and very sweet and loving and just expressive. That's how I remember myself being in the beginning. I was very, very timid at that time. Now I'm very bold. But back when I was younger, I was really, really timid growing up, like in the beginning parts of, you know, growing up and knowing that being called the F word at a very young age, and people calling you different things and family slurs, you know, because that's where it really started in home. Like, it started more so around family because they noticed that, like, as I grew up, like, I was very feminine. I did all kind of gestures. I was acting like a little girl. Like, everyone saw it. Everyone would talk about it. You know what I'm saying? And I just felt like people didn't really think that it was really that serious. Like, people thought that I was really going through a phase. And it was like, I wasn't going through a phase. Like, I felt like I authentically was really trying to be myself. Like, I was around a lot of people that was always saying, you know, you should be real, be yourself, be real. And, you know, going from being really young to getting to the point of life where I was able to, like, really notice that I was different, I was always a soft one. I remember being younger and, like, my stepfathers and the different ones that my mom did have, because my mom was, you know what I'm saying? But we're not going to get into that. That's going to be for, like, a whole nother video. But I used to be always get called, you know, that one. Like, I knew that I was oddball out. I knew that I was not like all the other boys. I didn't play any sports like that. Like, I didn't want to go outside and play with the boys. I always played with the girls. You know, I was out there step teaming out, playing Beyonce and them Destiny's Child, coming down the steps, hitting it in them. Like, I was always up in my sway, my girly boom, 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 boom. Like, you know what I'm saying? I was always in my girly sway. And I used to get teased a lot and get, like, made fun of as I was growing up, saying, like, you're too girly, you're feminine, you're gay, you're this, you're that. So then being young like that, people don't understand, like, that's already, like, being put out there and put in your face. Like, everyone felt some type of way when I really actually came out being transgender, like, as if it was, like, some sort of surprise to me. I felt like people were lying within themselves and not keeping it real with what was really happening in front of them. Because when I started dressing up, it's once I got to a little bit more of age where I was like, you know what I'm saying, like, I'm not about to fake the funk with this shit. I'm about to just go straight full-fledged, full force with this. This is something that I want. I don't care if I hurt anyone's feelings type of deal or dish. Like, you know what I'm saying? I have battled cancer at that time, lymphoma. I am a survivor, non-Hodgkin's, blah, boom, click, click, tween. You know, so, yeah, there's my scars and stuff. So, people are like, you're lying now. I got mutilated. A lot of people don't know about that, but that's the only reason why I'm strong and still hitting it. You know what I'm saying? And it is what it is. But as I got older, people kept trying to play it as if it was a joke. Like, this is something that I'm, like, trying to portray and do. And it was like, no, this is literally who I am. I haven't changed who I am. I haven't tried to act like I was anybody else. I never tried to act masculine. Like, I never felt like inside of my mind, inside of my body and my soul that I was a masculine figure. You know, I just knew that, like, I was a girly girl inside, like, my soul, my inner deep sway. Like, I remember this being, like, super young. Like, I'm not in my right body. Like, or if I'm not, like, something's not right, because why come I have to deal with this sort of situation? Like, and in by biblical terms, like, why do I have to deal with this sin already? And you already know as you're younger that it's a bad thing because of the way how people shy you and attack you, and mainly family, because, like I said before, it always came from inside and it worked its way to the outer side, you know what I'm saying? And then by the time you get old enough to understand what you're doing, you know, hopefully. Hot mess from within. But I remember basically, you know, saying, fuck this shit. Like, I'm about to just go out and do me. I'm about to be me, basically. I'm not scared. Like, what's the worst that basically can happen? What, I'm going to live the rest of my life not being authentically trying to figure out who I am, than to be caved into this fucking boxed in, soiled into this fucking collaborant of being in the matrix that everyone else lives in. Like, I'm sorry. I just never thought like that. I've always felt like whatever internally that I felt, which was in my spirit, which I thought that was also the goal. Like, you know what I'm saying? Your spirit holds who you really are and not your outer body, you know, because they all say in biblical terms also, like, this is only just the flesh in him. And I'm like, okay, yeah, this is really just literally, like, only the flesh, because, like, for real, like, I have not been wrong about my situation. Like, when it comes to me being a woman and feeling empowered as a woman, I don't know, from within there and within it, before I even started taking hormones, this is how it's always been for me. And I just feel like I've gotten a lot of backlash for being very open and honest at an early age, being able to go through school and be myself. And I've not changed once. I never felt like I had a means to want to be with a woman. Like, it never was like that. It never was like that. It was like I was the girl, the home girl. Like, I was always the guy. But, you know, I was stuck in these situations. But when I noticed that I was actually cute and, you know, and I could, you know, blend in. Bitch, life started to happen, like, from within. And I just really grabbed that situation by the horns, because I knew who I was authentically from within side. Because I feel like if I didn't jump off that ledge to figure out who I was, I would probably be somewhere mutilated, like, somewhere not knowing who I am, probably just fucked off. Like, and who wants to be fucked off? Half these people that think they know and that are gonna judge you for who you are and judge you for what you go through and disrespect you for your lifestyle, which is most of everybody. So I'm prepared to be attacked. I ain't worried about that, because I done already went through that part, so none of the comments are gonna faze me, period. You know what I'm saying? But most of us already know who we are, and a lot of us choose not to act on who you really are. And they're really, really sad and pissed when they see a person like me be able to stand up and be like, yes, I was born a man. Like, I'm not scared that I was born a man. I've known this shit since I was young, but my inner spirit doesn't feel like that. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, I clearly have male qualities to a certain extent when it comes to, like, certain shit. Like, of course, I was born a man, like, from within, but, you know, that's what happens when you're born what it is. But at the same goddamn time, internally, when I'm speaking, what's coming out, it's not no fucking like I don't know what that is. Like, I never have, and I never try to fake it with myself. And that's one thing I want to tell other people out there. If you are going through your transition or going through things, trying to figure out yourself, and you know who yourself is, you should just take that chance and just jump. Like, just jump off that fucking ledge and really, like, know what the fuck you're doing. You know what I'm saying? You have to know how you really feel within and about yourself, because a lot of people don't know that besides only yourself. And I've known this since an early age, like, that I was going to have to take on this situation, that I was going to have to take on this burden. And I've handled it very well to be at my age and at the life point that I'm at. You know, I've hit a lot of stumbles and stumps and bumps in the road, but at the same time, I've hit it. And that's one thing that no one was able to take away from me, is who I knew I was. And people can look at me dead in my face and be like, you know who you are. That's why a lot of people are scared of me. That's why a lot of people think I'm intimidating. I think it's probably why a lot of people feel like I'm so aggressive, because it's like, I know what the fuck I'm doing. I know what I fucking want. You can't tell me how I feel, no matter what any structure of anything says. How can you tell someone who they are and how they feel when half of us don't even know? Half of the cisgender people out there are married to people that they don't even fucking love for certain other reasons, and doing all this other adulterous and different type of things. Don't get it twisted. I'm mutilated and stoned out too, if it comes down to it, period. But I'm just saying, because y'all be the main ones trying to come for bitches, and it's like, you need to reflect and look on yourself. Don't worry about who the fuck I'm fucking on and sucking on and what I want, who likes me and why not. I'm a bad bitch anyway. I look cute. I look good. This no makeup to makeup, you've seen. So it's like, bitch, I have the confidence, and a lot of people don't have that star power and that confidence within themselves. And I'm sorry that I have it within me, and I've known that I was transgendered ever since a little kid, and I've always been flamboyant and feminine and always fucking cute and hitting it, like, and a lot of people hate you for being your authentic self. And like I said, this is going to be mainly a shorter segment on this situation. I'm going to actually make a longer video when it comes back to this situation, because I feel like I would go into more detail. But I want people in the story time to slowly get to understand who I am as a human being and as a person, as a black woman, you know what I'm saying? Even though I was born a man, for the people down in the comments, you're a man! Trump 2020, you're a man! Like, oh my God, press. Like, get your fucking effervescence, baby. Like, you're mutilated over stuff that you don't even like. And I would like to tell people out there, if it's something that you don't like and this is not your lifestyle and this is not the segment that you want to be on, bitch, stop watching me. You don't have to watch me. You don't have to say anything to me. You don't have to come into my sway. You don't have to be in my ambiance. This is my ambiance. This is where I come to help encourage others that don't have a voice, because I've always had a voice. And that's why bitches hate me, because, bitch, I'll say what the fuck needs to be said when it's necessary. But sometimes I don't, because, you know, I'll be trying to protect people's feelings and shit, because I don't want to be that confrontational. But you come for me, I'm going to come for you. But there will be a longer segment on this situation. I just wanted you guys to get a little bit more of my personality, and also know that I've been doing this for forever. This is nothing new. Like, bitch, I know who I am. Like, you're not gonna tell me. Like, no one's gonna tell me, period. Boom, boom, boom. Kanye dressed me up like a doll. And then I hit 6'9", tell him I'm a babe. Stay confident in who you are. Know who you are. You can live it as far as you fucking want to take it. It's all within yourself. Don't let anyone tell you who you are. Like, just do that shit. Sometimes you gotta lose a lot of shit just to get where you want to be and be who you are. Like, and I did that to be who I am. Like, I freed myself from all that. No matter what family says, no matter what friends said, like, no matter what anybody said, I have to free my fucking self. And we'll be back with the extended video on this. Boom, 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 boom.
So this is my skin discoloration fade cream. Nadania La La La. I don't know how to say the name of it, but it's for oily skin, and I tried it out and it's been working for me. I haven't seen anything wrong with this product yet. I really don't go into detail about knowing all that extra shit about the products, but for, you know, even skin tone, you know, I use this cream to help me with my fade marks so I can be a more fishy ass bitch, as you see. And then here I have Dr. Fred's Summit Skin Whitener, and it's a tone and a bleacher. So it's more of a, not a creamy texture, but more of a, like, pasty texture. And it smells really good too, but this is what I'm using to get away all those dark marks and shave marks.